over.
But we were full, all the beds were full, so everyone was coming. Even like discharged patients were sort of put temporarily in this room.
Here in Kunduz, we had real intensive care unit. I remember patient being intubated, paralyzed, and we were really giving the best we could have offered. And so now we did rounds again. I did rounds, but I did rounds about hearing the story of each patient. Wow.
There was a blast when he was crossing, so they found parts of his body inside and part of the body outside.
And I think hearing the stories of, or particularly about a patient that the younger was doing better, and then we've told the parents, come tomorrow because she's safer here. And then when they came back and claimed back the body the next day, they could only see ashes. There was nobody to pick up. So, yeah, a very profoundly disturbing experience.
In memory of Abdel Massoud, Abdel Nasser, Abdel Salam.
We had this, I would say, unique and very overwhelming emotional moment to bring our word of sympathy from across the movement to the families of our staff who lost their life.
And you, the families left to mourn.
So after the ceremony, we had a moment with the family to discuss with them in a more personal way. So it was a very intense moment. They shared their, I would say, their sorrow, but as well their anger and their question.